The devil can easily take you and destroy you. And sometimes, even if he doesn't take you and because there's space around you, the devil can easily enter you and make you Judas in the house of God. Today, every junk in the life of drunken people must go away.
Amen.
And that junk you've been holding in your kitchen is making the house smell very bad. You gotta keep it out. I am not talking about the trash in your kitchen. I'm talking about the trash in your life.
God
wants to come and visit him. God really wants to come to your house. But the trash is too much and he stayed there for so long, he's so messy and smelly. God cannot come and visit him. And because God wants to come so bad, but the trash is so bad too, God is angry at you. My brother, read on.
The Lord sold the Israelites into the hands of the Philistines and the Ammonites, who that year shattered and crushed them. For 18 years, they oppressed all the Israelites on the east side of Jordan, in Gilead, the land of the Amorites.
Yes.
The Ammonites also crossed the Jordan to fight against Judah, Benjamin, and the house of Ephraim. And Israel was in great distress.
They were in great distress, but go on.
Then the Israelites cried out unto the Lord.
They cried out unto God.
We have sinned against you.
We have
sinned against you.
Go ahead.
Forsaking our God and serving the Baals. The Lord replied, when the Egyptians, the Amorites, the Ammonites, and the Philistines, the Sidonites, and the Amalekites, and the Moabites oppressed you, you cried for me for my help. Did I not save you from their hands?
It's okay. It's okay. It's just when so many enemies were coming after you, last night, had it not been for the presence of God over your life, you could have died. Look at what just happened yesterday, 2 weeks ago, 3 days ago, last year. Look at what just happened. Had it not been for the mercies of God, you would have died. But how come your soul just so soon forgotten all the good things that God has done for you? God said that she asked you this evening that all the blessing he has given, all the grace, all the blessing, all the protection that has been offered by God, so soon and so fast, have you forgotten all this? Are you throwing all this away? Are you throwing all this away just because of some junk that is in your life? Today, if you and I will not throw out the junk in our life, the devil is ready to smash up again to us.
Tonight I plead the blood of Jesus.
For every junk in my life.
For
every sin in my life.
For
every wrong in my life. I plead the blood. And I ask for mercies.
I ask for mercies.
At every junk in my life.
At every trash in my life.
That they will go away. For me to serve you. Wholeheartedly.
Faithfully.
Persistently. That I might serve you. That you will be my God.
And I will be your servant.
All the days of my life.
I acknowledge.
That there is a lot of junk in my life.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
My brother, read on the last one. Go ahead,
John.
What?
The word says that. But you have forsaken me.
You are forsaken
and served other gods. Mm-hmm. So I will no longer save you.
Ah. Mm. That is the first time I've heard God telling his people that you sin against me. You see, some of you have persistently been doing something wrong. Some of you have bad attitude even outside. You repented and came to the church, and now you are in this church also doing the same thing that you see. The same confusion you used to create outside, you are in the house of God and creating confusion house of God is a junk. When you used to be in the world, you used to fight everywhere. I thought you threw out the boxing gloves, but you brought it to church and you want to fight
someone.
And you are fighting people in the house of God. If you behave like that, you'll be cursed. The Bible says the word of God is a double-edged sword.
Yes.
One part slashes for you to be their blessing. The other side cuts for you to be cursed. Which one are you choosing? You are choosing the one with a junk, or you are choosing a blessing?
So then you miss the command of the offer and as offer me.
Let me see those of you who are waiting for your job. And let me see those who are cutting for their blessing. Let me see all those of you who are here for the blessings of God. Everybody with a junk
couple.
Everybody, you know you got a bad junk. Please cover.
So them say,
because junk and trash things are bad. We normally hide it at the back. Everybody, every human has a bat in your life. Everybody has a bat in your life. But your junk is becoming too much. You have to try and bring it down. If I pass by your house and there's full of trash in front of the house, I will classify the people in the house as junk people. But today, that junk that is in our life, we gotta kick it out. Read the last part of that.
But you have forsaken me and served other gods. So I will no longer save you. Go and cry out to the gods you have chosen. Let them save you.
God said they should go out
and cry out.
God said, I'm not going to talk to you. Do you understand that God hasn't talked to people?
Yes.
Yes, because before someone will be born, if you read the Bible in the book of 1 Samuel, the Bible said for so long, God was not talking to Israel. You know what? Because there was a prophet in that land called Eli. Eli has a son called Hophni and Phinehas. They were a junk in the house of God. Because of one junk here, because of one junk in your house, one person, one is one trash can stop the whole blessing of God. But today, any junk and any trash in this house will cause the fire of God to turn you off of our midst. Come on, make some noise and turn that noise up.
Israel.
That is why when Hannah was praying for a son,
She saw the junk in the house of God. And she said, Lord, if you give me a son, because there's a junk in your house, I'll give my son back to you.
Yes.
That is why God gave another son. Some of you have been given wonderful positions in your life. And sometimes because it's so comfortable, it looks so glorious. And you are becoming a junk at the position. God is about to take somebody from the back. To come and take your position. So that in the house of God there shall be no junk. So that in the house of God there shall be no junk. How does he want any junk among us? God is looking for people with a pure heart.
Yes.
God is looking for people with a right spirit.
Yes.
God is looking for people that want to serve him no matter what.
Yes.
Some of you wonder why you cannot maintain friends. Nobody wants to deal with something that is nobody wants to deal with something until you realize there's a junk, you must throw it out. People will continue to stay away from you. Otherwise, everywhere you go, you'll be complaining and complaining and complaining. It is not somebody you should always be blaming. There's a junk in your own life that is
so
today, God is asking you and I to re-examine ourselves and find out where the junk is so we will get it out. Said, if you are interested in your junk, deal with it, don't call me. If you are interested in your junk, just maintain it in the house. Let your house be, the shoes are hanging on the ceiling, everything. Yes, it's your junk. Maintain it. But if you don't want it, then you and I will repent from our wicked ways and seek the face of God. God will hear our prayers from heaven. He will forgive us of any unrighteousness. He will bless us and heal our life. Then go to the Israelites,
yeah.
Go and cry out to the gods you have chosen. Let them save you when you are in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
But the Israelites said to the Lord.
Then the Israelites
said to the Lord, we have sinned.
We have
sinned.
This is the second time they're telling God, we have sinned. Go ahead.
Do with us whatever you think best.
Mm-hmm.
But please rescue us now.
They said they are so much desperately in need. They are seeking for the face of God. The Bible says if you persistently, earnestly will seek the face of God, no matter how unrighteous, no matter how wicked, no matter how bad you are, if you open your heart and seek the face of this merciful, this kind, this so sweet God who will sacrifice his only begotten son, that if anybody will believe in this son, the person will not die but would have everlasting life. If you and I can throw out every junk and seek the face of God, no matter what the short. We serve a God that is a God of solution. He will help you, he will heal you, and tonight you shall be blessed.
The Israelites said to the Lord, we have sinned. Do with us whatever you think best. But please rescue us now. Then they got rid of the foreign gods among them and served the Lord.
Then they got rid
of the foreign gods among them.
Then they got, tell somebody, get rid of your junk. Oh, don't feel shy. See, some of you are sitting by, you are sitting by somebody who knows too much of your junk. Look at somebody and tell the person, get rid of your junk. This person sitting by you knows a lot of the junk in your life. So you are feeling sad to tell that person to get rid of the junk because they know you got a lot. Please turn your finger to somebody.